Okay, I'll be taking a crack at this crock pot cake, of which I'll be using apple pie filling and light blueberries and blueberry syrup. Let's see. Now the recipe called for spice cake, but I don't have any, so I'm going to use the butter golden cake. Let's see. And one stick of butter, of which I'm going to sit like so. All right, I'll be back in about 2.5 hours. Okay, y'all, so this is a cake about 1.5 hours in. As you can see, it's bubbling on the top, still has to get done around the sides, but it looks pretty good to me. I'm gonna keep letting it do what it is. Okay, so this is about 3 hours in to the crock pot cake. Looks pretty good to me, but it still has a ways to go before the cake mix is the texture I would like for it to be. Now it seems the outer ends are cooking much quicker than the middle, probably because that's where I set the butter at, so more than likely that'll be a softer part either way. But it looks pretty good, but I'm gonna let it do what it's going to do a little bit longer, and we'll check back in about another 45 minutes to an hour. All right, here's our crock pot cake, about 3.5 to almost 4 hours in. As you can see, it is definitely cooking from the outside in, which is different from how we started it, with it cooking more so in the middle out because of the heat from the butter. I like the texture on the sides, it's getting a bit crispy the way I want it, so it is a little bit more soft, but it looks pretty good. So as of right now, it could be eaten, but because I like mine a little bit more done, I'm going to let it continue on just to see if it will get a little bit more crispy around the middle area. And more 9 times out of 10, it probably won't. It may not even get dark in color because the butter was sitting there and that's where it settled, which is fine because as we saw earlier, the butter did disperse all around the whole cake. It was just the majority of it was in the middle, so that part will probably be a little bit lighter because it did have most of the butter. So you already know that's the part I'm going for first. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and let this continue on cooking for a little while longer and see if we can get any more crisp around the sides, and then we're gonna dive in and see how it looks once we plate it. All right, so here we go with our crock pot cake about 1 hour later. As we said, the ends are now nice and still kind of soft, not crispy. Probably won't get crispy because of the method that we use to cook the cake in, but still very firm. In the middle, also just as firm, but just lighter in color, as we stated earlier, because of the butter being set in the middle. So that's a softer piece, but still firm to the touch. So we'll see how it looks once we cut into it. All right, so I'm going to try to get a chunk out of here and see what it looks like. You see, it's really soft. Maybe I should have used a different spoon. That looks good. I see the blueberries. Definitely use a different spoon. Don't do what I did. But it's not supposed to be one solid piece, again, because of the method that we use to cook it. More so like a casserole-ish type of vessel. Okay, so we have some of the crock pot cake in a bowl here. You can see the apples right on top. Let's see if I can show you. The apples here, kind of soft, the blueberries. Cake itself on the outside, of course, like I said, was pretty firm, but the inside is pretty soft, again, because of the cooking method. We got a little bit of apple, a little bit of cake, and the blueberry, let's say. It does have a crunch on the outside. Actually, I didn't think it was going to be sweet, but it's really sweet. I would do it again. Okay. Works for me, y'all. Let me know if you like it. So I took a nice big chunk out of the crock pot cake and tasted it. It's really good. The apples are somewhat sort of like an applesauce to some extent now that it's been cooking for some time. That's pretty soft. Actually, much softer than the cake. You can definitely taste the butter, the blueberries, and using some of the juice from blueberries definitely gives it sugar. So it's really sweet. You don't need any sugar. I think that if you were to do this in the oven, one, the cake may cook too quick. I'm just assuming. But if you cook it on low, it may work and it probably would give you a better crunch. But down on the sides and around in this area here of the cake, you can still get some crunch if that's what you're looking for. I don't know whether or not if you leave it cooking for a longer period of time, will it get any extra crunch, but because it's in a crock pot, it may not. But I would give it about an 8 out of 10. I would definitely do it again. You know, if you want a quick dessert, well, not necessarily quick, but a quick dessert that you don't have to do much to. Sunday dinner or something like that, you can leave on and go. I would say yes. So if you do use it, the recipe, let me know how it turns out. Okay.